Are you looking for a better way to assign work to team members, make sure that everyone can collaborate and stay on task inside of your software? Well, if so, look no further than this video. I'm going to be showing you three different ways that you can assign work to people using SmartSuite, which is a workplace management software. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner here at Gaff Consulting, and we make it our mission to help you automate the bullshit. We do that using no-code tools. No-code tools are an amazing way to increase your efficiency, and one of the best ways to do that is to learn how to leverage no-code automation. It doesn't matter what software you're using, automation follows the same rules, and I'm gonna teach you the basic fundamentals of no-code automation inside my free training. Go ahead and grab that at garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration, and check below this video for links to that. But without further ado, let's hop on into the heart of this video. We've got to find three different ways to assign work to people inside of SmartSuite. Now, before we get into the three different ways, the first thing I want to bring your attention to is the My Work section. So inside of SmartSuite, if we go into the upper right-hand corner, this checkbox here is My Work. And if I open this up, what I'm going to see is all of the work that's been assigned to me. It doesn't matter what solution this is in, whether it's the solution I have currently opened on my computer, or if it's another solution entirely. If it's in my workspace, if it's been assigned to me, it's going to show up in My Work. And this makes working in SmartSuite for workflow management just so much easier, because I don't have to bounce around from one place to another. So everything that we work on assigning here today is actually going to show up here in My Work. So let's take a look at how we get that set up. The first way to assign work is pretty straightforward. It's actually using the Assigned To field right here. And in order to have this work properly, we also need to include a status field. This way we can tell if the task has been completed or not. And lastly, a due date field. So any record that you want to assign to someone inside of SmartSuite should follow this pattern. Let's call this test one, and I will assign it to myself. By accessing this, I see a dropdown of all the people who have access to my workspace. So here I am in that list. I can assign a priority if I would like. I will skip it for this example. And then of course the current status of this thing, let's say it's in process, and then I'll assign a due date as well. I'll make that the 11th, which is 3 days in advance of our recording. You see that the due date actually calculates how many more days until this thing is going to be due. That's the little three that it shows right there, which is a pretty neat feature. Now, if I go up to My Work, I'm going to see that that is now assigned to me. Again, I am in the Assigned To example, and you can see that I have other things assigned to me here inside of different solutions. But this is the record that I just assigned. It's test one, and I can actually update the status of this thing right here from inside of My Work. So I can say ready for review, or I can say complete. And in doing so, I remove it from My Work, and it's also going to be updated here in the solution itself. So that's the first way, assigning an actual record to somebody. Again, it requires three different fields, the Assigned To field, the Status field, and a Due Date field. Now let's take a look at another way to assign things using a checklist field type. So here I've added a checklist field, and this is just one of the type of fields that SmartSuite offers. And if I go into Modify these settings here, you'll see that I can establish some defaults. So in my defaults, I've added thing 1, 2, and 3. Maybe I want to add a couple more defaults as well. Thing 4, update that field. And now anytime I create a new record, it will automatically get those 4 different things inside of the checklist. So let's do that. Here's a new record and I will call this test 2. And you automatically see that inside of my checklist here, I have 0 out of 4 items complete. Let's drill into that checklist by opening it up. And here we have things 1 through 4. You see, I can also add new things if I so choose, and each one of these things or checklist items can be assigned to someone and have a due date as well. So let's go in here and I'll assign thing 1 to me, and I'll assign thing 3 to me, and I'll pick some arbitrary due dates. Let's say this one's due on the 10th and this one is due on the 17th. I'll save this right here. And of course, you might assume that these two items are now going to be added to My Work. So let's go ahead and pop open My Work to confirm that. And here we are, those two checklist items. They both exist on the record test 2. And then we see that what's due to us is thing three, or in this case, thing one. And of course, we can change the status of these. They're either open or resolved. Let's go ahead and resolve those issues. We've now completed two of the four things that were from that checklist. So if we now close out my work and we go back, we also get the visual indication that this checklist is now 50% complete. Also note that inside of the settings for this particular field type, that is the checklist field type, I can also come in and say that users can modify or delete default entries, I can require an entry in the field, and I can allow whether users can or cannot create new entries. So you get a lot of control over the types of checklists that you can create. Now let's take a look at the third and final way to assign work to somebody, and that lies in the conversation here. So the conversation is a field type that will exist in every single SmartSuite app. In fact, you notice I can't even delete this particular field type. There's no way to get rid of it. So it's gonna be in every single app, whether you like it or not. So let's go ahead and start a conversation here. I'm gonna use the first test record again. This is test one. I'll start a conversation and I can at reference somebody. I'll at reference myself so as to not spam anyone on my team. And I'll say, this needs your attention. And you'll notice that as soon as I have at referenced somebody, I have this little pop-up that says, would you like to assign it to this person as well? So here I have a choice. I can at reference somebody in a conversation and get their attention and let them know that I need them to look at something inside of SmartSuite, or I can go a level further and say, I'm assigning this to you. I want to get your attention by at referencing you and make sure that you know that this is something that has to be completed by you. So let's go ahead and assign it to me and see what this looks like. Notice that I don't need a due date in this particular instance. I'll go ahead and send this message and then back out of the record. Let's pop up into my work and see what I have going on. There it is. I just got assigned this new comment. At Gareth Pronovost, this needs your attention. I have the status here of open. I can resolve it directly from my work. And please note that when you assign a comment to someone, as I just did here, only two people can resolve this comment. Either the person who was assigned the comment or the person who left the comment. In this case, I left the comment for myself, so I'm the only person who can resolve it. And so in order to resolve it, I can just come in here and mark it as resolved. That will remove it from my work. Or the other option, of course, is to go up into my work where we had this previously and just select resolved from the dropdown. So that's it. Three different ways inside of SmartSuite that you can assign work to your teammates and collaborate more effectively. I hope you got a ton of value out of this video. If you are not yet a SmartSuite user, please check out our affiliate link below and sign up there for your free account. Try it out for a little bit and decide if it's for you. Also, be sure to subscribe to this channel so you don't miss out on future no-code news, and I will see you in the next video.
As always, I hope you found that to be extremely helpful. If you did and you'd like to learn more, swing by our website and see how we can help. We offer a free Airtable crash course that will help you level up in Airtable quickly. And we also have some paid services, including hourly consultations with our experts. We have some online courses and a group coaching program. And for advanced needs, we can build a bespoke solution for you from scratch. So swing on by, and I look forward to connecting with you soon.